we've always had extremes and paranoid conspiracy theorists among us. We've always had their influence in our politics. We've had presidents attacked by extremes before. President Franklin Delano Roosevelt being called a communist and a socialist on the floor of the House. Dwight Eisenhower being called a dedicated conscious agent of the communist conspiracy. Teddy Roosevelt actually coined the term the lunatic fringe to speak to groups on the far left like the anarchists who assassinated his predecessor, William McKinley. So we've faced a lot of these forces before. We've defeated them, but we need to recognize them for what they are. They're symptoms of what Richard Hofstadter famously called the paranoid style in American politics. Back in the 1850s, the Know-Nothing Party emerged, which was virulently anti-Catholic and anti-immigrant. The anarchist movement of the late 19th and early 20th century, a movement that encouraged revolt against the United States government in the belief that it was simply another imperialistic power like the monarchists over in England, that actually claimed the life of President William McKinley. Ku Klux Klan is another example, which is infamous in the minds of many Americans today, began in Reconstruction at a time when Southerners felt that the federal government was oppressing them. We had the rise of Joe McCarthy and the John Birch Society in the 1950s, and far-left liberals got misty-eyed talking about Uncle Joe Stalin. The point is that we've always wrestled with extremes in our politics. This is nothing new, and very often, the echoes of extreme claims still influence our politics today. They're resuscitated every generation. If we recognize the origins of these debates, if we recognize the origins of these fears, we can have greater perspective on them. And we can remember the wisdom of Dwight Eisenhower, who said, look, all the usable surface is in the middle of the road. The extremes of left and right are in the gutters.